So you just received your Nakto Cruiser Model e-bike. The first thing you're going to want to do is unbox it and unwrap all packing materials, and it should look like this. You have your frame, user's manual, toolkit including hex and crescent wrenches, axle caps, front wheel with disc brakes, seat, pedals, charging unit, and keys. So let's attach the handlebars. First, you will need to remove the neck bolt and washer from the frame. Then place the handlebars onto the neck of the frame and replace the neck bolt and washer. Screw down the neck bolt, but don't crank it tight just yet. Now let's put the front wheel on. Place the forks onto the axle, making sure to insert the disc brake into the caliper. Align the axle locks with forks and tighten the axle bolts with the crescent wrench. Push the axle bolt caps over the axle bolts. Tighten the caliper with the hex tool. Tighten here and here and here and here. Then adjust the brake line tension at the bottom of the caliper. Until the fully engaged brake allows for a 1 to 2 finger width space between the brake clutch and the handle grip. Now align the handlebars and tighten all 3 neck bolts. Insert the seat post into the frame and tighten with the quick release latch. And under the seat here is the quick release latch, giving you easy access to the battery. Now let's attach the pedals. You'll notice there's an L and an R for left and right. Simply screw the pedals into the pedal arms and tighten with the crescent wrench. Now let's take a look at the battery. Engage the quick release under the seat. Insert the key into the battery. While pushing, turn the key all the way to the left. Now the battery is unlocked and you can remove. Align the slot to reinsert the battery. Push down until it sits flush against the bottom of the housing. Now turn the key to the right to power up the battery. Press and hold the power button to turn on the LCD. The plus button increases the degree of power assist, and the minus button decreases the degree of power assist. And the right handle grip is your throttle. Here's your front brake, your bell, LCD, gear shift, and rear brake. Now you're all set to go, but let's talk about charging your battery. Plug the charger into the battery body here. You will see a red light go on the charger. A full charge will take between 4 to 6 hours. When you see the green light, you are fully charged, although you will need to leave it charging for 1 additional hour before use. However, it is okay to leave it charging overnight. If you have any additional questions, use the scan code to access our website. Okay, you guys, have fun.